Hey guys, welcome to part 3 of my Mac Pro 4.1/5.1 tutorial series. And in this video, I'm going to show you, obviously you can see this in the navigation below, how to upgrade your Mac Pro with a state-of-the-art SSD so that it's like a really fast video editing animal. And for this, I'm going to use a 1 TB Samsung 860 Evo. This is the new 860 Evo series that came out. And as you can see, it supports the serial ATA3 standard. And unfortunately, these old iMacs, they didn't support the SATA III standard. They are only limited to SATA II. And to get around this, I've looked online and I found an interesting solution that is friendly to your budget. And that is just using like a adapter card that supplies the Mac Pro with SATA III speeds, because honestly that makes a lot of sense. If you put in a really nice solid state drive and you connect it to the internal SATA II connectors, you're only gonna get half the speed that this solid state drive can deliver. But with the Otherworld Computing Mercury Accelsior S, you can utilize the full speed. So that's what we're gonna install right now. And guys, I'm very, very excited about this because previously I was using a 1 TB SSD in my old iMac and that only had SATA II, and I always felt a little bit sad using a state-of-the-art solid state drive only with SATA II. So this is a really good combination. And I think this was like 50 bucks, 60 bucks or something. Sometimes you can pick these adapters up really, really affordably. So why don't we just open up the case and take off the panel, and then I'm gonna show you how to install this inside. So guys, I put the Mac on the side here, and basically what we're gonna do, we're just gonna take this out of the box here real quick. Obviously I've used this particular drive before, so it should be pretty straightforward. You just take out your solid state disk drive. Doesn't matter whether it's a 1 TB one or a smaller one. The important part is that you use this in conjunction with SATA III so that you get the full performance that this drive can deliver. So next up, let's quickly look into this Otherworld Computing Mercury Accelsior card box. So you get like a really nicely printed manual that explains how to install it. And basically it's just you mount that onto the card, secure it with these screws that are delivered here, and then you plug it in and you're ready to go. And I tested this. You can install the operating system also directly into the card. Like if you have a new drive, you can put this in. If the operating system is already installed in here, as far as I tested this, it also did boot up. So let's quickly take this out and see what we've got. And I also noticed that's a really interesting way they designed this card. You can imagine these solid state disk drives, they consume way less power than the traditional hard disk drive down here, but still Otherworld Computing took the time and engineered the card so that if you put this in here, let me show this to you in a second here. I just plug this in, and obviously the heat, if there's any heat on the solid state disk drive, it can dissipate on top, but they even left like a spot at the bottom, which I find is kind of cute. So let's screw in these 4 screws and then install it into the iMac. So I secured these 4 screws and I'm ready to install the card. Maybe I just put it to the side real quick, because one thing I forgot is obviously we have to remove this bracket here in the side as well, but that only should take a few seconds right here. So now that this bracket is removed, what I'm going to do is I'm going to install this in the top slot, and maybe I can zoom in for you a little bit. I hope this shows, but you see on that there are like 4 PCIe slots, 16-1, 16-1, 4-lane, 4-lane, and I'm going to put this in the top one that says RAID, and I tested this. It works fine. You don't have to put it in a 16-lane slot. It works fine in this one that's labeled RAID, and we're just pulling this back right here. Let me zoom out a little bit right here. There we are. This was a little bit overexposed. And yeah, I mean, that's literally how easy it is. It's no rocket science. Everybody can do it. I think this the last part where we prepared the install disk and flashed the firmware, that was considerably more tricky because you have to pay attention to all these details and do it in the right order. This is now set and we can boot up in High Sierra on the super fast SSD. I'm very excited about this. So let's put the bracket back on and look at the performance. And I already know it's gonna be twice as fast and we're simply gonna run. I'm gonna show this to you, this Blackmagic disk speed test to see the entire performance gain that we got from using this really useful Mercury Accelsior S. So let's jump back to the desktop.
If you want to test the speed of your hard disk drive or whatever drive you have, in my case, we are now testing the newly installed Samsung 1TB solid state drive with the Otherworld Computing Accelsior card. I just hit speed test. And as you can see, you get full SATA III speeds out of this drive. Just to give you an idea, comparing this before and after, before the speed was only half of what I have now. So if obviously you can take the SSD and plug it directly into your Mac, whether you put it in one of these disk drive slots or below the optical drive, there's one free connector that I told you. So, but as long as you use a SATA II, which is what the Mac Pro standard comes equipped with the hardware, you only get about half the speed of what I'm getting right now. So from experience, what I can say, because I'm just working on all these video projects right here for these Mac Pro tutorials, because it's a bunch of videos, it is really fast. If I start up the Mac, it's really fast, meaning the boot up is really fast. I just turn it on and a short moment later, bang, the operating system is booted. I log in and that works really fast. And what I'm trying to convey to you is if I do video editing, it's really fast. So basically what this upgrade allows me, and guys, it's a little bit funny, like I'm editing the video and recording the testimonial at the same time. I can skim through these videos, I can open up projects really fast. And I really feel like what it basically does, because it can pull the data, wait a minute, maybe I can stop this here. It can pull the data from that SSD so fast and push it into my system. What I mean is the system's memory, because I upgrade the memory as well in part 5. So basically it reads the data really fast out of this SSD, stuffs it into this 24 gigs of memory, and the CPU can work with all this stuff blazingly fast. So for video editing, which can be quite intensive if you have lots of files, that's really great. Only thing I have to say, that's fair, I'm not working on 4K footage. That might be another story, because I noticed that when I used the Sony Action Cam, that the 4K footage, if you really put it, recorded, for example, in the Sony X-Ray codec, the files are just ginormous. So that might be a whole nother ball game. Personally, I haven't tried this yet. I haven't made the switch to 4K yet, and I'm not planning to do it until I have a bigger monitor. But so far I'm really super happy with the results. So let's jump back away from the desktop and come to the conclusion of this tutorial.
So guys, this concludes the update of the solid state disk drive in my Mac Pro 4.1 early 2009. And maybe if that's the first video that you watched, maybe you don't know about the previous episodes, tutorials, where I first showed you in part 1 how to fix the Bluetooth issue that the Mac Pro can have, increase the performance of the Bluetooth by attaching like this $10 external antenna. Then in part 2, I showed you how to install macOS High Sierra on the 4.1, which Apple doesn't allow you to do, but which you can very easily circumvent by updating the firmware, and also showed you how to make this installation medium. And yeah, part 3, that is what we're just watching right now. And next up, part 4, I'm going to show you how to massively upgrade the graphics performance to your personal need by picking a graphics card in next episode. Personally, I have the RX 560. And then next up, in part 5, I'm going to show you how to upgrade the memory. And then in part 6, I'm also going to show you how to upgrade the CPU. But I'm still waiting on the CPU, so that's going to be released last. So I see you in the next video when I do the graphics card. Stay tuned.
So guys and girls, up next is the graphics card. As you can see, I have the RX 560 here. Obviously, you could pick the bigger 580. However, in my case, I found the 560 to be totally sufficient. So I see you in the next episode. And as a subscriber on my channel, surprisingly, more and more people have already subscribed. So I'm guessing you will do the same thing. Awesome, guys. So let's hop to the next video.